Hey guys, it's Matt with Natural Environment Aquatix. Today we're going to do a video of the five easiest fish to breed. So let's check them out.
Before I get into the top five, one thing we do want to with breeding fish is food and also water changes. When the babies are born, you do want to do water changes at least twice a week, sometimes three times a week. It does help them grow. With food wise, we would recommend Rapashi Spawn and Grow. This will help them grow pretty quickly and feed them the best food that you can. Extreme's also another food. This Nano is actually very, very fine, so the babies will have no problem eating it. And then of course water changes. You want to make sure you have clean water for the babies to survive and your tanks. So let's get on with the show. So number five, we're gonna go with angelfish. Angelfish, they will pair up, so a male and a female will pair up, and what they'll do is usually they lay eggs on something that is straight, like that pipe right there, or a plant, or even on the glass itself. When the female lays, the male will come up behind her and fertilize the eggs, and then they will both take turns taking care of the eggs until they become wigglers. And once when they become wigglers, they will detach from that spot that they lay them on, and then they will attach to the parents. Both male and female will take care of them. They will eat off the slime coat of the angels on the side, so it's kind of really cool watching them go from one side to the other side with each of the parents and taking care of them. And then once when the babies are big enough, they will detach and become free swimming. So there are the angels at number five. Right, and at number four, we're gonna go with live bearers. There are multiple live bearers out there that are actually very good parents and good breeders. Guppies are one, swordtails, mollies, and platies are another. Usually you want to have one male to every two to three females. More females makes him happier. As you can see, the females are a little bit smaller than the males, but when they do give birth, they do get a little bit of fat to them, and then the males, as always, stay colored up as they are. Like I said, it is live birth, so as soon as they give birth, they do not take care of their babies. They just kind of go on their own. So it is really, really, you know, kind of nice to have a female by herself in a tank. Then once when she lets go, you can pull her from that tank and have the babies grow up by themselves so that they do not have to survive without getting eaten or taken out by other fish in your tank. All right, and number three, we're gonna go with the bristlenose plecos. Bristlenose are really hardy fish and actually very easy to breed in a tank. That is a male right there, so males will get that bristle on top of his nose, as you can see right there. And then the females, I can find her, will not have the bristle noses on her nose. So females have no bristles, males have bristles. They breed by putting in a cave. A female will lay the eggs, and then the male will fertilize them, and then the male will go on watch with them. Usually you want to take the angels, not the angels, I'm sorry, the bristle nose out of the tank and put them in a smaller tank to breed, and then the female will kind of just lay the eggs, and then the male will fertilize them, and then he'll keep watch over them until they're born, and then you can grow them out and reintroduce them to your tank. And that is how you breed bristlenoses. All right guys, for number two, we're gonna go with the African cichlids. African cichlids are pretty easy, probably one of the easiest fish out there besides the number one that I'm going to show you. African cichlids are mouth brooders. As you can see right there, that female right there, she's actually got a clutch in her mouth. Females only hold eggs. Males will fertilize them, and she will take care of them until they hatch. You really want to do close to four females to every male. They do colonize, so it is easier for you to do more females. The male will be happier. That goes with peacocks and haps will do the same thing. Females will hold them until they are, like I said, they're ready to hatch. And when they hatch, and then when they're ready to release them. And once when she does have them in her mouth, she will not eat. So you want to make sure when you do, usually when you do breed cichlids, is you want to take the females out, put them in their own separate tank, so that the female will not breed with her, will try to breed with her, because she will not be able to breed with her because she already has a clutch in her mouth. So that is number two, African cichlids. Alright guys, and the number one fish is going to be convicts. Convicts are probably the easiest fish to breed out there. They're so easy that you can probably put them in a bucket of water and they'll breed. Males are usually longer and a little bit more bigger than the females. The females are show color. I think we have a female in here. You can see her, where's she at? Oh, she's right there. If that is a female. So females will show a right underneath her, yep, there she goes. She turns towards me. We'll have a little bit more color on her belly, and then males get a little bit bigger and longer. They are egg scatterers, so once when they breed, they will scatter the eggs, they will watch the eggs, they will hatch, and then they will let them swim off by themselves, but still protect the nest as they do breed. So that is number one, is the convict cichlids.